بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. لا
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected viewers, continuing on our program, looking at some of the ayats and some of the verses that we recite in Taraweeh tonight. And today we are doing the 13th juz, which coincides with the 12th night of Taraweeh. And we know that the first quarter of the 13th juz coincides with the end of Surah Yusuf. And Surah Yusuf is a tremendous incident. Yesterday we mentioned that it is أحسن قصص, the best of incidents. And we will just look at one or two important lessons from this incident. The Supara in the juz starts off with a very important lesson. Allah Ta'ala says, and many ulama and mufassirin have quoted this to be the statement of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, when he said, وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِسُوءٍ, that I do not absolve my nafs. The word nafs can mean and have different interpretations. Can mean our carnal self, our desires, our lust, our passion. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that carnal self, I do not absolve it of blame. Because the very nature of our carnal self, the very nature of our desire is such. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ. Our desires lead towards evil. إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Except for the one whom Allah has mercy upon. Therefore, never ever trust your desires. There is a beautiful dua that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it was a dua of the pious people, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَلَا تَكِلْنَا إِلَىٰ أَنفُسِنَا تَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. Oh Allah, do not even leave us to our desire for the blinking of an eye. For even that amount of reliance upon desires can lead a person towards evil. Continuing, there is one poignant moment of this incident, which is in the 89th verse of the surah, of Surah Yusuf. Keep in mind the great trials that Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam undergoes. He is put into a well to die. Somehow or the other, he is then taken out and he is sold into slavery. When he comes into sold into slavery, he comes into the house of a prominent person in Egypt. He is seduced by the woman of the house. He comes out of there proclaiming his innocence. For some reason, he is put in jail. After jail, he gives the correct interpretation of the dream of the king. He is taken out of jail. And because of giving the correct interpretation and giving a solution to the interpretation, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam is put upon the treasures of Egypt. And now he is in a situation of dispensing those treasures. When his brothers come, then again a long incident goes. But I don't want to go into it. Just give you this after he is now sitting in a position of authority. His brothers have come to seek the treasures and the wheat and the food that he is dispensing with. Now he reveals himself to his brothers who had initially tried to destroy him. And look at how Allah Ta'ala puts it forward. قال هل علمتم ما فعلتم بيوسف وأخيه إذ أنتم جاهلون. يوسف عليه الصلاة والسلام turned to his brothers. Do you recall what you did to Yusuf and his real brother when you were ignorant? When they hear Yusuf, the ulama say some 40 years has passed. They thought him to be destroyed and they didn't know and they could not foresee that he would be in a position of authority over them. They look closely and they said, أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُفُ. Verily you are Yusuf. And he said, yes, أَنَا يُوسُفُ وَهَذَا أَخِي. I am Yusuf and this is my real brother Binyamin. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah Ta'ala has favored us. And not only me. Subhanallah, look at the humility of Yusuf. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرَ. He who adopts taqwa and he has perseverance upon the commands of Allah. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُذِيُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah will never allow his effort to go to waste. And they turn around asking for forgiveness. And Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam said, La tathriba alaykum al-yawm. Go, I have forgiven you, may Allah forgive you. Then he asked about his father. The same words Hazrat, our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used when the people of Makkah were at his mercy after he conquered Makkah. And the people said, how are you going to treat us? And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them the same words that Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam told unto his brother. Go, there is no reproach upon you. Go, I have forgiven you, may Allah forgive you. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam takes his kurta and one of his qamis, which our ulama say it was a very blessed kurta because it came from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, the forefather of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, when he was being put into the fire and said, take this qamis of mine, take this kurta of mine, put it upon the eye of my father, he would restore his blindness. Because Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, crying for Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, had lost his eyesight. Walamma fasalat al-ayr, Allah Ta'ala says that when the brothers of Yusuf left Egypt, قال أبوهم, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam said, إِنِّي لَعَجِدُ رِيحَ يُوسُف, I can sense the smell of Yusuf. And they said, Are you gone? Are you gone mental? How can you find Yusuf? It is 40 years since he has passed away. And he said, I know Allah Ta'ala has made me smell Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is also amazing, the qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he could not sense Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam was in the well when he was just few kilometers away from him in Kin'an. But here when Allah Ta'ala makes it known to him, when Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam sends his brothers from far away Egypt, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam comes to sense it. Nevertheless, Allah Ta'ala says they come. And there's a very interesting incident made mention that Yusuf Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, when the brothers come and said, Yusuf is alive. He asks, how is my Yusuf? And they reply, he's the king of Egypt. And Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam said, I don't ask you whether he's the king of Egypt or not. I'm asking you, how is his iman? Subhanallah. Look at the quality of a Nabi. He said, I don't ask you about his worldly position. I'm asking you, how is his iman? And they give him reassurance. And then in the 101st verse of the surah, now that everything has happened, he is rejoined again with his family. The dream that he had seen, that he is in a position of authority, the parents and the brothers making sijda out of respect to him, which was permissible in that religion, not in our religion. Then he makes dua, subhanallah, viewers. Something for us to see, his humility. Rabbi qad ataytani min al-mulk, wallahi, you have granted me kingdom. وَعَلَّمْتَنِي مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ, you have taught me the interpretation of dreams. فَاتِرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, O creator of the heavens and earth, أَنْتَ وَلِيِّ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, you are my protector both in this world and the hereafter. تَوَفَّنِي مُسْلِمًا وَالْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ, let me die as a Muslim and let resurrect me with the pious people. This was the humility of a Nabi. So it was with our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he triumphantly entered into Makkah. No show of pride. And Sahaba said he had his head bowed down upon his camel in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, Alhamdulillahi wahdah, wa nasara abdah, wa anjaza wa'dah, wa hazama al-ahzaba wahdah. All praises due to Almighty Allah who has made this come true. And so it was with all many other Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. Towards the end of the surah, there is a very beautiful proclamation about our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Verse 108, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي, this is my way of life, I call people towards Almighty Allah. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي, I do so with foresight, and me and those who follow me would also call towards Almighty Allah. It is the responsibility of those who follow our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that they should also call people towards Almighty Allah, the way it was the calling and it was the passion of our beloved Nabi Kareem. From the quarter of this juz, we start a surah known as Surah Ra'd. In Surah Ra'd, Allah Ta'ala has made mention of His power and His greatness. وَفِي الْعَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ, it is in the fourth verse of the surah, of the chapter. Allah Ta'ala says there are vast tract of lands. Sometimes in these lands you have vegetation of أَعْنَاب وَزَرْ وَنَخِيل, of dates, of grapes and vineyards and corn. Sinwan wa ghayru sinwan yusqa bima'in wahid. Subhanallah. Sometimes one tree, one branch, And from that branch, from the same tree, watered from the very same source of water. And in there you find, وَنُفَضِّلُ بَعْضَهَا عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ فِي الْأُكُلِ. You eat one portion of the branch and it is sweet. And you take another portion and it is not sweet. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمِ يَعْقِلُونَ. Verily in this, there are signs for people who have intellect. This comes from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the 10th verse of the surah, سَوَاءٌ مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَسَرَّ الْقَوْلَ وَمَنْ جَهَرَ بِهِ. It is equal to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you reveal something to him or you keep it concealed in your heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything that you do. وَمَنْ هُوَ مُسْتَغْفٍ بِاللَّيْلِ وَصَارِبٌ مِنْ نَهَارِ. Whether you do something in the darkness of the night or you do it in broad daylight, Allah ta'ala knows it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the 11th verse of the surah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah does not change a condition of people. There are two interpretations of this verse. One is Allah will not change the good conditions that are with people until they change it by their evil ways. So if Allah has given you a favor, Allah does not want to take it away from you. Unless you, by your conduct, not showing appreciation for what Allah has given you, you make Allah take it away from you. That's one interpretation. Another interpretation is Allah will not change a condition of people until they are willing to change themselves. Continuing on that, there's a very beautiful aspect of Allah Ta'ala's greatness compared to us seeking help from someone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Ta'ala says in the 14th verse of this surah, وَالَّذِينَ يَرْءُونَ مِن دُونِهِ. Whomsoever you ask for assistance besides Allah, لَا يَسْتَجِيهُونَ لَهُمْ. They can't respond to you. Their example, كَبَاسِتِ كَفَّيْهِ إِلَى الْمَا. Subhanallah. It is like the one who stretches out his hand when there is rain. And he stretches out his hand towards rain, thinking that just by merely stretching out his hand towards rain, that rainwater will come into his mouth. It will not come. Just as that is impossible, similarly it is impossible for anyone else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come to your assistance, unless if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also in the 28th verse of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Those who have iman, their hearts find contentment in the remembrance of Allah. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Only in the remembrance of Allah will hearts find contentment. If you seek contentment anywhere else, you are not going to find it. Then towards the end of the supara and the juz, we start off surah Ibrahim. As can be gauged from the name of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, specifically his dua. But I must make mention of one or two very beautiful verses in this regard. In the 7th verse, Allah ta'ala says, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَعَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you are grateful to Allah for what Allah has granted you, Allah will give you more. If Allah grants you something, you are grateful, Allah will grant you more. Of the same and even perhaps better. But if you are ungrateful for what Allah has granted you, Allah's adab is also severe. And if Allah's adab is severe, part of that adab could be Allah ta'ala could take away what Allah has granted you. Then towards in the 22nd verse of Surah Ibrahim, Allah ta'ala speaks about shaitan telling human being, when human being on the day of judgment will start blaming shaitan for leading him towards evil. And say, shaitan will say, وَمَا كَانَ لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. Don't blame me. Don't blame me. I told you to do something. I didn't force you to do it. I made it enticing to you. But it was your choice. It was your choice to do the evil. فَلَا تُلُومُنِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Do not blame me, but blame yourself. This will be like adding salt to our wounds for the people who have done evil, who have followed shaitan in this world. Shaitan telling them, don't blame me, blame yourself. Let us conclude with some of the dua Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam made. And that dua is why the surah is known as Surah Ibrahim. Such a beautiful dua. When he left Hazrat Hajar and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam alone in the Kaaba and the Baytullah. And he left them there and he said, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَتِي بِوَادٍ. Oh Allah, I'm leaving my wife and child in a barren desert. No water, no vegetation. Why am I doing it? Oh Allah, in the Baytika al-Muharram, because it is your sacred house. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ السَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, to establish salat. فَجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ. Oh Allah, turn people towards me and my family. Until today, there is not a revealed religion that does not show respect and appreciate Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And he said, Alhamdulillah alladhi wahaba li ala al-kibar. And I praise you Almighty. In my old age, you granted me Ismail and Ishaq. Inna Rabbi la sami'u al-du'a. Verily, you are the one who respond to people's dua. رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, make me steadfast upon salat. وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي. And also make my children steadfast upon salat. رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَى. Oh Allah, accept my dua. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Oh Allah, forgive me and forgive my parents and forgive the believers on the day of Qiyamah. With these beautiful words of dua, we come to the conclusion of today's program. May Allah Ta'ala accept that also from us, and may we also make the same dua, and may Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala accept our duas also. Wa akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.